the house abandoned. I don't know what you're trying to use. Play a game. You don't know the name of your own game? You put the cassette in the player and press play. Ooh! Now that's loud. It's upside down. What's that say? That sudden sound really scared me. Oh, now, yeah, we've lost power, I guess except for this, because we turned on the generator. Right? But the lights are also hooked up to the generator. You pull up to the driveway of the family holiday home and park the car. It's dark, but it's clearly neglected. You remember being told to check the glove box before going in. You can't stand to be near this place. Alright, open box. Inside is a key and a handwritten note from Dad. You take both. So now I can't stand and be near this place, which is different. You don't recognize the handwriting. It says, get out, get out, get out, get out. Okay. Get out the car. Get out the car. Press enter. Well, I have to exit the car. Force the warped car door open and fall out. The house looks abandoned. There is a yard to the side. Wood creaks in the wind, and all happy memories are gone from this place. There is no love here. Wow. I have the key as well, right? It's the key of the house. Alright. Go to yard. Shall we start the generator again? You step through the debris to the backyard. The grass is overgrown, and weeds crawl up the side of the house. It's not a nice place to be. You clutch the note, needing to look around. Needing to look around? Grass? Sorry, I don't know what you're talking about. Look at weeds. How about the house? The woodwork is rotting. The paint is peeling. Right, look around. It's obviously hinting that. There's an old generator next to you. Okay. Start generator. There isn't much fuel, but the generator starts up. Okay. Are we on a timer with the generator? The old generator can supply power to the house, and it is doing so. Okay. Exit. Go back to the front of the house. Unlock door. The click of the lock hurts to hear. Huh. Okay, we're gonna have a creak here, you know that. You reluctantly step inside the front door. Pitch black, but your senses are punished more by the smell, stale air and damp. This could not be less inviting. The note burns in your hands. You feel compelled to read it over and over. Do I? Do I have the note? I can't read it because the lights are out, so... Turn on lights. Afraid of what you might see, you flick the light switch. The light flickers on and off. The walls are falling apart after years of neglect or worse. There are stains and trails open. Upstairs, the sound of an alarm clock blaring. Someone else is in this house. It can't be. Somehow the alarm stops. You can feel the panic set in. Well, I'm the one who turned it off. You were still in the hallway. The noise has stopped, but you feel a presence. Someone is in the house. They should not be here. There's a kitchen and a living room adjacent and stairs leading up. The note feels disgusting in your hands. Do you want to read it again? Does it say something different now? I can't read the note. It's bleeding. Seriously. Go to... Yeah, I'm glad we were able to turn off the clock without going up there, because... Damn. That was, would have been annoying. Go to living room. You enter the living room. The living room, although hardly an appropriate term, the future is threadbare and worn. The note is fixed in your mind. Dread fills the pit of your stomach. This is not a nice place. Is the note still bleeding? The note, always changing, now reads, "Get through this. I don't care if you want to or not." Huh. Really? Alright, I want to look at the furniture and then look around. Look. So that's me up there. Because I turn off the clock. So I'm playing the game, and then there's a me inside the game coming through the same house. That's what it seems like anyway, right? Was the light flickering before turning on? The future looks disgusting. There is no way you would sit on it. See that? Is that random or are we losing power? Look around. Run down and empty. Abandoned. And for good reason. What reason is that? You return to the hallway. Go to kitchen. You go into the kitchen. The kitchen stinks and feels completely unfamiliar. The tabletops are rusted metal and there is a carcass. What? There's a carcass on the table? There is writing on the wall and the utility room door has a red X painted on it. We never did find the key to that door. So there's a carcass here. Okay. Carcass. Alright, so carcass. You look closer, but can't tell what it is or what it was. Yeah, I didn't think that would work. Look at... Tabletops? Tabletops. I don't know what you're looking at. I'm looking at... Oh, look at the writing. Read, read wall? Oh! Good God, that's louder than the intro music. In blood, the number 1986 is smeared across the wall. 1986... Does that happen every time I read the wall? Read wall. No? Maybe just the first time? Or maybe it was completely random. Was this always here, this? Okay, look at door. Door has an X on it. There's a red X on the door. You assume it's paint. Yeah, must be paint. It feels like the note. Well, I haven't looked at the note since it came in this room. The paper now feels like fabric. It's covered in blood. You can just make out the words. There's nothing for you here. Okay, open... Oh, enter in the container. Yep, yep, yep. Tabletops. Open... door. The door is locked. I can't get in there. Not yet. And the key doesn't go to it, right? Use key. The key doesn't fit. It comes as a relief. Okay, time to go upstairs. Your shoes are wet. Why are my shoes wet? Blood? Obviously. Naturally, I have to look at the... no, shoes. Shoes, man, shoes. Okay. Go upstairs. You head up the stairs, they creak. Oh, good God. It's me coming. Same, but different. The landing has access to your sister's room, your room in the bathroom. Oh! Behind the door, phone starts to ring. You don't understand. Neither can he. Okay, it's loud. Answer phone. Can you hear him answer the phone? Your mind hurts and you taste iron. Voices spill out of the phone and into the room. Whoever's in there should not be there. You need to hang up the phone. I do, whoever. You consider the worst. Listen? You can't hear yourself think. It's too much. Hang up. Relief. Same but different. Pictures are all over the wall, but something is different about them. This is pretty cool. I like the way it changed like this. The pictures are of your family. The eyes have been scored out on all. Really? Look at eyes. You can't type ahead. That's the thing. Look, family. No. Okay. Go in bathroom. Yeah. Let me guess. Tub full of blood? You enter the bathroom. The bathroom feels disgusting. Every surface is covered in a layer of oily grime. The sink is a haven for all kinds of bugs. Alright, doesn't mention a tub. Every surface, grime, sink, bugs. The sink. It's disgusting. Grime and dead bugs. The taps won't budge. Oh, I never did try to turn on the faucet. I don't know if that would have worked before. Look at bugs. I don't know what you're looking at. Look. Grime? Don't know. Okay, look around. I forgot to look around the kitchen. A broken mirror hangs above the dirty sink. Taps rusted in position. Okay. Am I still me? You can't bear to look at yourself. Okay. I want to go downstairs and look around. I haven't looked around the kitchen. Or the hall, I don't think, either. Some things are revealed when you do that. Sink, bugs, okay. Exit. Step back onto the landing. Look around. The landing is bare and worn. Photos adorn the wall, but all misaligned. Okay, I want to go back downstairs now. That should change. You are still in the hallway. No, it used to say you are back in the hallway. I don't think I've ever looked around in this room. Look around. There are stairs and doors to kitchen and living room. Okay, go to kitchen. Anyone who's like familiar with my channel knows I'm very thorough, or at least I try to be. Look around. There seems to be writing on the wall and what looks like blood. Okay, exit. That's all. That's it. I thought there would be something else we might find, but no. Yeah, shoes are wet. The bad thing is you have to wait for all this text to scroll. So it should be flashing 0000 at the clock, but because what time is 99.99, you know, that digits wouldn't even go there. You head up the stairs to where the noise came from, which is different. Go to... I'm dreading going to my room. I don't know what the hell's gonna happen. I'm gonna see me, but different. Jennifer's room is boarded up. You can't bear this. Okay. Yeah, I was afraid of this. Go to my room. Ready for anything, guys. The door is bolted shut with a 4-digit combination lock. Oh, 1686. Unlock door. Will it give me a prompt to enter the... You grab the lock. The lock is rusted, not used in years. The key in your hand weighs heavy, the note heavier. You grab the lock and can now input the code. It's a combination lock. Why did it mention that the key in my hand weighs heavy? Oh no, 1986. The lock clicks open. Same but different. Oh, I have to... Seriously, now we have to open the door separately. And wait for all that text to scroll. You open the bedroom door. Is that my shadow? Look at me. I don't know what you're looking at. Look, oh. I didn't go in it? Wait. Go in my room. I didn't go in it yet. You enter your bedroom. The bedroom feels utterly familiar. The walls are damp. But you've been here before. In front of you, a lone person sits in front of a computer screen. The lamp is on. The clock reads at 99.99. You shouldn't be here. I shouldn't be here. You grip the note tight. Oh, I have... I can hear me breathing. I have not looked at the note. Look at... person. Rocking back and forth. Consumed by guilt. I'm gonna look at the note in a second, guys. Look at a computer. Sorry, I don't know what you're looking at. Look. Clock. Read note. Oh, God. I'm sorry, Jennifer. I'm sorry, Mom. I'm sorry, Dad. You haunt every step I take. Even in this place. It was out of my hands, but still you punished me. I can't be with you now. There's nothing left to do. I'm consumed and confused. This has to end now. It does. Is that still part of the note? Or is this... Talk to person? You struggle out a hello. Everything you say. Everything you are, I am. A feeling of hopelessness. Your grip on the note tightens further. There's nothing left to do. Kill me? I can't turn around to see me. Look at me. I don't want to turn around. I can't look at you. Exit. You can't leave here. This is where it has to end. Am I supposed to kill myself? Turn around. I don't want to turn around. Okay, we can't look at ourselves. I mean, other than kill myself, I'm not sure what else to do. Turn off computer. I don't know what you were trying to use. Get up. Don't understand. Turn off TV. I can't interact with the computer. I can't interact with the, I can't look at the computer anymore, which is strange because I always have been able to. Come play the game with me. Play Aim. Use phone. Pick up phone. I know it's not ringing, but answer phone. I'm guessing I have to kill myself. I'm just trying to see if there's any other option. Turn off light. It doesn't understand anything else at this point. Doesn't even know. Kill me. You are pathetic. It was all your fault. Say it. No. Oh, please stop. Never. It was all my fault. Say it. No. Just say it. I will not say it. Okay, it. It was all my fault. About your fault. Just say it. Okay, damn it. I said it was my fault. It's my fault. My fault. It was all my fault. He's walking behind. Finally. He's on the left side of me now. Or me. Okay, guys. Interesting. Very interesting. So, yeah, stay tuned for next episode when we play the second chapter or game. The Lab Conduct. Alright, guys. See you then. And always, seek adventure.